The road to destiny is not always marked.
Morrow is back there. Johnson over to Ramsey.
It's best traveled one step at a time. Herb Brooks found the way, coaching the U.S. Olympic hockey team to its storied victory over heavily favored Russia in 1980.
You've got 10 seconds. The countdown going on right now. Morrow, up to Schultz. 5 seconds left in the game. You believe in miracles? Yes!
Look at Herb Brooks.
No notes tonight.
Talent, preparation, passion. Herb Brooks' success was rooted in the notion that ordinary people are capable of extraordinary things.
Weak side, weak side, weak side, Bobby!
In 1986, Brooks proved it again as head coach of the NCAA Division III men's hockey program at St. Cloud State University.
I think he was the happiest. Matter of fact, I know he was his happiest when he was in St. Cloud.
Why St. Cloud? After the miracle on ice and six seasons coaching professional hockey?
My dad was from the east side of St. Paul. He wasn't a flashy guy. He wasn't a materialistic guy. You know, it wasn't about the money for him. He was a grassroots, build the game from the ground. And he looked at the opportunity in St. Cloud to turn that into a Division I hockey program, and he took it on 110%.
Herb Brooks had dreams of his own to grow the game at colleges and universities across America, a dream he shared with his former coach, John Mariucci, the godfather of hockey in Minnesota.
You know, John Mariucci's dying wish was for him to do that. Mariucci would thought it was ridiculous that Michigan had seven Division I college hockey programs and Minnesota had two. And so the first thing my dad wanted to do is really elevate the legend of John Mariucci, because when John died in 1986, there was a lot of people in Minnesota that didn't really know who he was. And so it was my dad that spearheaded the naming of Williams Arena, Mariucci Arena. My dad knew that, you know, by bringing St. Cloud to Division I, he knew that Bemidji State would probably follow. He had an idea Mankato would be there. I mean, that's where he wanted to take college hockey. And I think it all started with him literally knocking on doors in St. Cloud to get that program to Division I.
In one season under Herb Brooks, the Huskies took home a Northern Collegiate Hockey Association Conference Championship and finished third in the NCAA Division III National Tournament, putting SCSU hockey firmly on the map.
You know, my dad, he loves a challenge. He loves a battle. I always thought if he wasn't a hockey coach, he would have been a great wartime general. He would have been a great trial attorney, or he'd have been a great, 60s radical, because he was a fighter.
Come on, Middle, what are you calling? Get it in.
If you think of that combination of a personality and say, you know, St. Cloud State, go to Division I, it was perfect.
He's one of those guys that brought out the best in everybody, whether it be the guy running the Zamboni to the guy shutting out the lights at night. He's one of those guys that I didn't know how much I loved hockey until I got coached by Herb.
Mike Brodzinski planned to leave college hockey after his third year until he heard Herb Brooks was coming to St. Cloud.
Yeah, it was my senior year. We were playing in Plattsburgh. It was for the Division II-III title. I remember Herbie come up to me and saying a couple words before the game about, it's just another game. It's nice to go out your last game of college on a winning note. I ended up scoring a goal to break the school scoring record against Bemidji State. And after the game, he came around to pick up the jerseys, and Herbie walked over and grabbed mine. It's one of those times you just don't forget, and he threw it to me and said, I just want you to have this. You know, it was one of those things that I won't forget. I got the jersey at home still. So it was a great deal. And I tell you, for his passion of the game, from the first practices all the way through till the end, he was there night and day. He never left without giving us some words that made you want to get back there the next day and prove him wrong or prove him right. You know, so he was an amazing guy.
Brooks went on to become head coach of the Minnesota North Stars, New Jersey Devils, Pittsburgh Penguins, and other professional teams. His hand-picked successor, Craig Dohl, coached 19 seasons at St. Cloud State and moved the Huskies program, step at a time, into national prominence.
Herbie was one of the three great mentors I've ever had in my life. He made you believe that you could be better than maybe you thought you could be. And he pushed. He was tough. But when you were doing things good, he patted you on the back. It's an innate ability to be able to get the best out of people without them rebelling against you. In many ways, the players were in awe or kind of in fear of him, but it really wasn't, fear isn't the right word. It's a respect, and you don't want to disappoint him. I was blessed and really lucky enough to get picked by Herbie to go be his assistant. And then when Herbie left a year after he was there, I was elevated to the head coach for the first Division I season and somehow survived for 19 years. So it was good.
It's what Herb Brooks hoped to accomplish, build collegiate hockey in Minnesota and share it.
In a state like this, I mean, you can do it. Hockey is the fabric. You know, it's our sport. And there was room for growth.
I think we'd be only right to have the rink at St. Cloud named after Herb Brooks. But I think he'd feel honored and privileged if it was named that, if he was alive today. I don't think there's any question that rink should be named Brooks Arena.
You know, it's a great success story. If you look at the last 20-some years, what that program has done and accomplished. And to know that Minnesota, the state of Minnesota, has two Division I hockey programs, one named after John Mariucci and another arena named after Herb Brooks, I couldn't see a more fitting situation. I'd be great for the game, great for St. Cloud, and I sure hope, you know, the people at Minnesota understand that, and that's the way my father would want it.
He really believed, I believe, that he felt that he was going to do everything in his power, and we lost him far too early, that he was going to make hockey better in Minnesota. Very proud of the state and hockey in the state and this country. And that's what he was dedicating his life to. And there was a time in his life where he, a period where he could give back. And he did it. Look what we became.
Join the Huskies at Herb Brooks National Hockey Center on the road to destiny.
You believe in Minnesota?